everybody, and welcome back to my channel. So today I was thinking for my third video, I would do kind of like a question and answer video because I asked everybody on social media to vote and tell me what video they want to see next. And you guys voted for a question and answer get to know me video. So here I am. I thought this would be a good idea because my last two videos were makeup tutorials. So I just wanted to take a brief little intermission and have you guys get to know me, and then we will be back to the makeup tutorials. So I went on Instagram, Twitter, and Snapchat and asked you guys to ask me questions. I got some very good questions and some crazy ones, of course. And yeah, so I am going to be reading the questions from my phone. I screenshotted them and I will be answering all of them truthfully and honestly, 100%. So with that being said, let's get started. Y'all, it is so damn hot in my makeup room. Oh my God. Like, it's already hot outside. It's like 85 degrees in Chicago today. I just have 3 big ass windows of sun just beaming down on me. So, and I have like this long ass jumpsuit on. Woo, she's hot. One of the questions I got a lot is, what race slash ethnicity are you? And if y'all didn't notice, the Nigerian flag is in my bio pretty much across all social media platforms. My dad is Nigerian, he was born there, my grandparents live there, and my mother is white, Nigerian and white, plain and simple. Makeup Fun wants to know, what made you move to Chicago? So for those of you who don't know, I was actually born in Chicago and I moved to Racine, Wisconsin when I was 8 years old. Why my mom and dad decided to move to Racine, Wisconsin out of all places to live, I have no idea. The most boring place to live ever. Like, I hate it. I hate Wisconsin. It's so boring. Everything closes at like 1:30 a.m. You're not able to buy alcohol past 9 p.m. Like, ridiculous. Like, it's crazy. So I hated living there. I especially hate Racine because it's just small. When I was 23, my best friend Edel actually already lived in Chicago, and she was like, Sky, like, why don't you just move down here and move in with me? And I was like, sold. So I, within like 2 months, I got my shit together, moved to Chicago, and yeah, that's how it happened. But I like Chicago because it's such a bigger city. It's just more fun. It's more connections to make. It's just more opportunities here. It's just a better atmosphere. I feel like the people here, I just love them. So do I like Midwest weather? Absolutely not. Like, when I tell y'all I hate the winter, it gets like 40 degrees below zero here, and I want to take my talents eventually to warmer weather. Maybe, I don't know, but yeah, we'll see. For now, I like living here, and this is where I am. This is where I'm gonna stay for a while. So what is my birthday and what is my sign? So my birthday is May 29th. I am a Gemini. The best sign ever. Geminis are very misunderstood. We're honestly hated. Like, we're definitely one of the most hated signs of the zodiac. That's just because y'all don't understand us and y'all can't handle us. And yeah, we're pretty much the best. I love Geminis. Sarah Janae G wants to know, how did I get into makeup? I got into makeup because, honestly, I went to go get my brows waxed at this nail shop, and this lady fucked them up so bad. They were literally like so thin, and my eyebrows have never recovered since then. So then I'm like, God damn, like, these, I'm not about to be walking around with these thin ass eyebrows. I noticed everybody, you know, started filling in their eyebrows. So I was like, oh, okay, let me learn how to fill in my eyebrows so I'm not walking around with these thin little lines looking crazy. So I started to learn how to fill in my brows, and after that, it just continued, and I was like, oh my God, I know how to fill in my brows now. Let me learn how to highlight and contour. And I just remember sitting in the mirror with all of this like light and dark marks all over my face, thinking like I knew what I was doing and I didn't. I looked terrible. Then after learning how to highlight and contour, I eventually wanted to learn special effects makeup for some reason. So I got into learning how to do special effects. And then after that, I was like, okay, let me learn eyeshadow. And I started doing eyeshadow. And eyeshadow was the hardest thing I've ever did in my life. Like, it took me so long to get good at eyeshadow, you guys. But I practiced every single night. Like, I would dead ass sit down. I had like this little skinny like floor length mirror, like those cheap ones, and I would sit on the ground every night with my makeup practicing, fucking up my mom and dad's carpet, which they still haven't forgiven me for. I would practice every single night and boom, I'm here I am now. I guess I'm good at makeup now. Young Sunflower wants to know, do you regret not re-enrolling into another college after getting kicked out of the first one? So for those who don't know, I got kicked out of school after my first semester. I went to UW-Whitewater, which is University of Wisconsin-Whitewater, and I got kicked out after my first semester because I think I had a 0.9 GPA. And I never went to class because it was just like I was having too much fun. The school couldn't like handle how much fun I was having, so they kicked me out. And I actually did. I went back to school the next semester. I enrolled in a community college after. And yeah, and then I transferred back to a university and I was doing really good. I was getting really good grades, and then I had the opportunity to move to Chicago and I was just like, I hate school. Fuck school. I hate it. And then so I dropped out and moved to Chicago. Will I go back to school? Maybe. For now, I can't stand it. I hate it. I'll sit in class and think about a million other different things that I could be doing. But I do think, you know, maybe one day I could possibly. Who knows? For now, though, it's just not in my life. I can't fit it in my schedule. So someone asked, honestly, I just want to know how you're doing since you moved back to Chi. Thank you. That's so nice. When people ask like, hey, I just want to know how you're doing, I appreciate it so much. So I'm actually doing really good. I feel good. I overcame a lot of the things I had to go through last year, and I'm in a way better position and a way better spot in my life. And I love life now. Last year was a different story for me. This year, I feel good and I feel happy. So thank you for asking. So Naomi asked, what is my favorite food? Honestly, y'all, we could literally be here for a year if I'm gonna list all the foods I love. But my favorite foods are egg rolls, manicotti. I love sandwiches. It's so weird. I love like turkey bacon like sandwiches, like in wraps. I don't know why. I could eat those everywhere. I love obviously Nigerian food, Indian food, ooh, steak tacos. I like Caesar salads. When I tell y'all, I like so much shit. Ooh, I love burgers with fried eggs on it. I like soul food. Oh, hands down, top three. Fried chicken, mac and cheese. I love greens, y'all. Like, ooh, I'm getting fucking hungry. Kayla Michelle wants to know, what is my biggest pet peeve? Honestly, you guys, I deadass have 30 of my biggest pet peeves. Like, I'm very irritated very easily. I hate when people talk with their mouth full of food. I hate when people smack and chew with their mouth open. I hate when people are walking in front of me very slowly because I'm a fast walker. I hate repeating myself over and over again. I hate when people talk over me. I hate when people try to argue with me when I know I'm right and I'm always right. I hate when people touch my shit and use my shit and like take it without asking. I might kill you. And I hate when people wake me up out of my sleep. Those are probably my top pet peeves. David wants to know, where do I see myself in 5 years? In 5 years, I honestly see myself being a full-time you know, makeup artist, influencer, YouTuber. I want to really create my own eyeshadow palette with a brand that honestly would be just one of my biggest goals. I also want to create an eyelash because y'all know I love my lashes. Those are my biggest goals. And I hope I can achieve all of them as long as I work hard and stay consistent and persistent. I got asked, what are my favorite qualities in a guy? And honestly, I am extremely, extremely picky. Like, if I look at a guy and I don't like their shoes, I won't even speak to him. If I look at a guy and I don't like his haircut, I won't speak to him. But I feel like being picky is the best way to go, honestly, because I mean, a lot of these guys, they're just not worth it. So my favorite qualities in a guy are, hands down, you have to have hair. You can't be bald, honestly. I can't do it. I'm not at that stage in my life where I can be with somebody who's bald. You have to know how to dress. I love the way guys dress, so that's like a big, big thing to me. You have to have a sense of humor and you have to be able to laugh and kick it with my friends. If you don't have a sense of humor, there's no way me and you are gonna get along, and there's no way you're gonna be able to get along with my friends. So you cannot be gang, you can't hang, and on to the next one. And you have to be like in control, you have to be assertive. I have the biggest, strongest personality, and honestly, if you cannot take control or be assertive, I will walk all over you. So I need a guy that can like put his foot down and not be weak. You know what I mean? I got asked about 100 times how I am handling my breakup or how I got over my breakup. And for those of you who are new to me and knowing me or following me, then you might not know that about 6 months ago, I got out of a relationship that I was in for 6 long years. So from when I was 19 to 25, I was in a relationship with somebody who is a really great person, but we just weren't great for each other. And I am handling the breakup really well. You know, I think I just drank my life away. I just try to have as much fun as I can. I spend a lot of time with my friends, and my friends are very fun people. So I feel like I'm distracted a lot of the times. I work a lot also. I'm started filming, so I have things to take my mind off of going through a terrible breakup. So I'm okay. Some days I have very terrible days. Some days I don't think about it at all. You know, it's up and down a lot of times. Lately it's been worse than usual, but I am just focused on me, my life, and achieving goals that I have set for myself. So I will be okay. Anybody who is going through a breakup, you will be okay. Honestly, it's hard as hell. It hurts like hell. It feels terrible. It feels like you have lost your heart, but you really will get through it and you will be okay, and you will have new and better experiences, new and better feelings. And love you will experience again. And yeah, so we just need to take one day at a time. Anybody who is going through a breakup, it's one day at a time. I got asked if I've ever traveled outside of the US, and if not, where do I want to visit? So unfortunately, no, I've been stuck inside the ghetto United States of America my whole life. I have not traveled outside of the US, but the first place I would want to go is Nigeria to visit my grandparents and my family members, of course. After Nigeria, I need to make it to Greece. I need to make it to Bali. Is high on my list. Bora Bora, Turks and Caicos, an island and water. Anywhere where there's an island and water, I want to go. I need to go to Thailand, like Fiji. There's so many places I want to go. And I need to make it happen. So a question I got a lot is, what are my favorite shows? If you guys follow me on Twitter, you know one of my favorite shows is Shameless. I love Shameless. It is one of the best shows. Then I love Sons of Anarchy. I can't even explain how good Sons of Anarchy is. Every episode like makes you feel sick to your stomach, like, because there's too much drama, and those are the shows I live for. I like Breaking Bad is one of my favorite shows of all time. That was a great one. I remember I used to just sit down all day, watch every episode. Desperate Housewives is iconic and legendary. If you have never watched Desperate Housewives, like, we could never be friends, because what have you been doing with your life? I got a lot of questions about my go-to makeup look and what it consists of, and this is honestly my go-to makeup look, my go-to full coverage makeup look with eyeshadow. This is literally a look I do so often. So if you want me to do a video on my go-to full coverage makeup look, then let me know in the comment section and I will make that my next video. Brianna Lynn wants to know what my favorite things about myself are. Oh my God, there's so many to name. Literally, what don't I love about myself? I love everything about myself. I am a true Gemini. My favorite thing about myself is probably my ability to not take life too serious, to be able to laugh through hard situations and make a joke out of everything. I honestly think I'm just a cool ass bitch. Like, I don't have to try too hard, and I really like that about myself. Like, I don't need to take on everybody else's, you know, personalities to make me. Like, I'm just me. I talk how I talk, I act how I act, I joke how I joke. Like, I'm just me, and I like that. I've never been a follower. I've always just been me, myself. Like, I am who I am. Either you're gonna like it or you're gonna like it, because why wouldn't you? Someone wants to know, who are my favorite exes and why? Well, I'm here to say I have no exes. I don't know who those men are. I've never heard of them. I wouldn't know them if they walked past me in the street. I'm sorry to those men. A lot of people wanted to know what my biggest fears are. Centipedes. Like, I won't play with centipedes. If I see a fucking centipede, I'm jumping out the window. Centipedes disgust me. I do not play with demons. Brown Sugar wants to know, what is my favorite sign for women and men and why? My favorite signs for women are Geminis, Leos, Capricorns, Libras, and that's it. And my favorite signs for men are, I really don't like men, and I really don't care for their signs. A question multiple people want to know is, what is the craziest fight I've ever been in? And honestly, the craziest fight I've ever been in is when those linebacker ass West Side bitches ran in my house when I lived on the West Side and tried to like fucking jump us. You guys know the burners on the stove? They were like throwing those at us. I think like one of them tried to pick up like a Jose bottle and like hit us with it. One girl was like trying to hit me with her keys in her hand, like trying to like fuck up my face. That was honestly the craziest fight ever, because I sat down, I thought I was getting ready for a party. It was my birthday weekend. I thought I was about to go to a day party. Next thing I know, a stampede of linebacker West Side bitches run in my house, and I'm fixing my eyebrows. I'm like, what is that noise? So I go out, and all of a sudden, I kid you not, 8 bitches ran in my house and got to like thinking they was about to like beat our ass, put us in the hospital or something. Luckily, I walked away with no scratches, because they were like fighting me down my hallway and like I'm trying to like defend myself or whatever, and then I realized my door is to the left. So I'm like, oh, I slid in my room, locked the door, and they couldn't touch me anymore. That was the craziest fight. I am going to do a story time about that, y'all. Don't even worry. It will be coming soon, I promise. Those were good times. Really, really, really good times. No, I live for a little action, a little drama. Dumbest reason why I've gotten into a fight. I would say the dumbest reason why I got into a fight was this girl thought she was this guy's boyfriend, and my friend used to like mess with this guy, but she wasn't his girlfriend. Another girl was his girlfriend. So she like threw a drink on my best friend in the club or whatever, and then we jumped her. That's probably the dumbest reason, because it's like, you're not even his girlfriend. Another girl is his girlfriend. Like, why do you think you're his girlfriend? Or how many girlfriends does this man have? That was probably the dumbest reason why. Everybody is asking, what is my favorite alcohol? My favorite alcohol is tequila. Tequila is honestly the best thing that has ever come into my life. You know, on my bad days, he's there for me. On my good days, he's there for me. I love Don Julio though. Don Julio was like my main man. I like Don Julio better than Patron. Anything tequila, I'll drink it. Shit, I love it all. I do not drink dark liquor, y'all. I hate dark liquor. Like, I can't even swallow it. I can't stomach it. It just won't go down my esophagus. So a lot of people are asking if I have a boyfriend or anybody I'm dating seriously since my breakup. And the answer is absolutely not. Never again. When I tell you never again, I never want to be in love again. I never want to experience love again. I have not met anybody worthy enough for me to even take serious on that level. I can't do it. I won't do it. I just don't want anything to do with it anymore. Maybe if the right person comes along, maybe. I just don't have the time, the energy, the patience. I'm honestly extremely, extremely nonchalant when it comes to men and dating. I don't care if I don't hear from you. I don't care if you don't call me. I won't call you first. I won't text you first. Like, if you want to see me, you know my number. You know what to do. Set up something. Set up a date. But like, I really don't care. I just really don't care. But if any guys are watching this video and you're over 6 feet tall and you have dreads, a couple tattoos, maybe you have a beard, I'm here. They want to know what my favorite color is. My favorite color is black. I like everything black, black this, black that, black clothes, everything black. Black is literally life to me. My whole closet is black. I don't remember the last time I wore a little bit of color. Black is my life. So Ashley wants to know what a guy has to do to get my attention. I would say nothing. Don't do anything. Don't speak to me. Don't approach me. Don't message me. Like, literally, do not do anything. I'm the type of girl, like, if I want to speak to you or if I notice you, if I'm attracted to you, if I want your number, I'll talk to you first. Like, you don't need to say anything to me. I don't like being approached. I hate it, honestly. It always catches me off guard. Like, they'll come up to me and be like, hey, I'll just be like, no, sweetie, not today. I don't feel like it. I'm not in the mood. I don't feel like holding a conversation. I don't feel like being nice. Like, no. If I want you, I'll let you know. If that day never comes, then that means I don't want you. What do I like to do for fun? I like to drink. I like to party. I like to online shop. I like to sit around and talk shit with my friends. I like to go out to eat. I like to play with makeup. I like to blast music in my kitchen and dance around the house when nobody's home. So I hope you guys enjoyed me answering a couple questions about me. There was a lot of questions I couldn't really answer on here because my family watches my YouTube channel, and you know, we'll keep those things for like Instagram. Thank you guys so much for watching my video and hanging out with me for a little bit. I really enjoyed answering these questions for you guys. If there's anything else you guys ever want to know, don't hesitate to message me, DM me, comment on my videos. It doesn't matter. I will answer anything you guys want to know. Again, like I've stated in my video, if you want to see me recreate my go-to full coverage makeup look, please comment below or let me know some way on social media that this is what you want to see in my next video, and I will do it for you. Thank you guys again. I love you so much. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe, and I will see you in my next video. I love you and have a good week.